What's the most embarrassing idea that crossed your mind lately? Careful, AI might be able to read it. Sort of. Researchers have developed a device that can translate thoughts into words. Writing messages, browsing the internet, or even controlling your phone completely just by thinking is getting closer to reality. Here's how it works. Researchers in Australia have created a special cap that reads brainwaves. The person wearing it silently mouths words while reading a sentence. That helps the brain process words more clearly.
At first, we used the deep learning model to translate the brain signals into the intended words.
Then, an AI model converts the thoughts into written language.
We use the large language model to make the match of the decoded words and make up for the errors.
Right now, the AI gets it right about 75% of the time. The goal is 90%. And this technique doesn't just work with words. In Japan, study participants looked at 10,000 pictures and had their brain scans recorded. Those scans were used to train an AI. Later, the model was able to recreate those images just from brainwaves. Tech that translates brain activity is called a brain-computer interface, or BCI. The devices come as wearable caps or tiny chips that are implemented into your brain. For now, the research is focused on medical applications, and we will get to that in more detail. But first, what role could BCIs play in your life? Imagine writing an email, scrolling through social media, or texting someone without touching a single device. You might even be able to share your thoughts directly without speaking at all. Sounds futuristic? In medicine, brain-computer interfaces have been tested with great success. For people who are paralyzed or unable to speak, this technology is life-changing. They're already helping some patients use computers, express themselves, and regain independence. And it's not just about reading brain signals. Some BCIs can also stimulate the brain like a two-way street. This technique, called deep brain stimulation, could help prevent epileptic seizures by recognizing signals and sending stimulation to prevent them. Researchers are also exploring its potential to treat depression, schizophrenia, and addiction. Of course, reading brain activity brings up some serious questions. Where is your brain data stored? Who owns it? And what could tech companies do with it? Experts are concerned over the lack of regulation and the risks of giving too much power to tech companies. Imagine getting ads based on your most private or even subconscious thoughts. Would you really want a company like Neuralink or anyone else inside your brain? So, what do you think? Is this a medical breakthrough, or do the risks outweigh the benefits? Let us know.